has been a process. And even if we give another period of time, it will be a process. God has come through for us. I can tell you this constitution is for posterity. It leaves Kefa Omai and the rest of us. So, this is what we are going to do. We are going to, first of all, like I say, we have had a constitution, they looked at it. They sat with the task force on the work which had been done. It's a process. They are all here. Every region, or rather block, was represented. And I want to thank God so much for you, men and women of God, because you burned the midnight oil. Sometimes out here you are at this place, you are at that place, and if there is anything we can do, servants of God, is to honor the work this team has done. Can we give them a clap? It's not easy. It's not easy, let me tell you, to sit for several hours and come up with a document like the one you are seeing. It's not easy. Even to write a book. And therefore, I would want us to straight away just go into the promulgation of the Constitution. Let me ask a question. And the question is, how many of you servants of God will say, Presiding Bishop, a time has come, we have to promulgate that constitution that has gone through the due process? Can I see by the show of hands, all of us, as many as will say, yeah,
yes.
Is there a no? Cheers, can you hand over that constitution?
And now, hereby now present to the chairman of Redeemed Gospel Church on behalf of the task force, the proposed Redeemed Gospel Church Constitution.
Shall we all stand up? Shall we all stand up and give the Lord a clap of praise? As I hand over now, this is our document, Your Grace, the Apostolic Bishop, that is going to lead us, guide us. Of course, the Bible is supreme. The Bible is supreme, but according to what we have heard from the lawyer, we abide by the laws of the land. After this is registration, and then we shall abide by what is in here. And much of it is drawn from Scripture. So it gives me a singular privilege as a presiding bishop of Redeemed Gospel Church to hand over this proposed constitution, which is now officially going to be our document for you to dedicate it before God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I've also tried to undergo to lead, and I thank God for the Advocate Morris. He's a born again advocate. He's really the son of Bishop, one of our bishops, and he has worked so hard with another advocate. And we have, since when the ministry began over 40 years ago, we have never had a constitution which has been covered by so many people. We used to work it about 4 or 5 people and then we announced. But now it has gone across nearly all regions. And it has taken over 1 year to make it what it is, over 2 years. So may the Lord be glorified. And right now, I want to dedicate this constitution before the Almighty God, in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Spirit. Father God Almighty, we dedicate this constitution to you. Can you switch your hands here?
Oh, yes.
We dedicate this constitution to you, my Father. I pray, God Almighty, hear our cry. Servants of God, I am happy with what you are doing. Keep the work going on. I appreciate the task force that has reviewed our constitution. And the leadership of the General Secretary, Bishop Dr. Kanya, who was the chairman and the secretary, Dr. Joshua Matheka, This team has done a good job. Our constitution is now one of the best in the evangelical churches. And I speak from the bottom of my heart because I am the president of evangelical churches in East Africa. I also thank our two lawyers, Maurice Mulay, advocate, and Maurice Kimuli, who is not with us today, who have really helped in giving us legal advice. The constitution that we have launched today states that the regional bishop shall serve for a term of 5 years, which may be renewed once. Those who came into office in March 2012, your first term ended in March 2017, while we were in the process of reviewing our constitution. Having seen your good work, I now direct that you continue in your second term up to March 2022. When your second term will end, the others who joined after March 2012 will go on as per the current constitution. Our constitution has created 5 offices which are very important running the Redeemed Gospel Church at the national level. They include the office of the presiding bishop, deputy presiding bishop, general secretary, deputy general secretary, and the treasurer. I will work just not by slowly to put some people in those offices, like deputy presiding bishop. I will announce or send a message to all the bishops wherever you are to announce in your car or in your regions who has become deputy very soon, who is the deputy presiding bishop. As a founder of the ministry, I have right to appoint those people. There are the bearers of these offices form the RITC National Executive Committee. As the founder of this ministry, I want us to have a smooth transition to the new constitution. I would not want to see another shakeup in the ministry. I allow all the bishops finish their terms peacefully, and thereafter, when everybody has read and understood the new constitution, I will fill the other vacant position one by one as we go. And I want to say this, all the bishops, particularly those who have struggled with them, there was this big struggle in the ministry. When you finish your term, you are not going to leave your office like that. You are going to be a divisive board in your region. So we shall talk that later. Because we have done a lot of work and we have struggled so hard, I don't want anybody to look just to start pointing you as if you are finished. So when you are finished, you have to go. However, today I give the following directives. Bishop Kefa will remain the presiding bishop of the Redeemed Gospel Church until the end of his term for 5 years, which will end 1922, March 22. Bishop Kanya will continue being the general secretary of RGC until the end of the second term, which will end in March 2022. I appoint Joshua Madeka of the as the regional bishop of the New Yaka region and the deputy general secretary of the Redeemed Gospel Church. And we have in the ministry. I will soon give names of the national treasurer, David presiding bishop. I have said before, some regions are big and they need to be subdivided so as to bring services closer to people. Today, I will appoint a boundary review task force, review boundaries of Machakos, Makueni, Kitui, Nairobi, Central Mount region, so as to create two more regions. When a region is big, I would say a region with 200 churches, 150. You even get confused how you can reach those churches. And we feel we need to create small regions that you can even go around and supervise and you feel comfortable. The following are members of the task force. If you are here, you can stand. A boundaries review task force. Work on that. Apostle Wilson Njuguna, Apostle Peter Brown, Bishop Francis Mutua, Bishop Maurice Omondi, Reverend John Kaduma. They are mixed up, Apostolic Council, Governing Council, and Mount Rio, Kaduma and Anoka Mount Kenya region. Also, Thomas Deto, Machakos region. The Reverend Benedict Isilo, Nairobi region. Reverend Paul Madenge, Makueni region. Reverend Peter Zile, Kitui region. And we have more to add to that because we could not reach other regions where we feel we need to cut those regions to small parts. Task Force Madenge, their work. The task force will combine Nairobi and the Central Mount region and from the two regions create three regions, Nairobi North region, Nairobi South region, and the Central Mount region. That's how we are going to divide Nairobi. The task force will combine Machakos, Makueni, and the Kitui region, and from the three regions, create four regions, Machakos, Makueni, Kitui, and the Yaka. The task force will independently review the boundaries of the said regions, then consider number of church and the financial strength of the churches to ensure each region is self-sustaining. They should not be guided by the administrative boundaries. The task force should report back to me within 3 days. The Apostolic Council has resolved to consecrate our mother, Reverend Josephine Kitonga, who is our mother, as our bishop. This will be done in the month of October 2019. This will be communicated later. All the apostles will be consecrated into the office of the apostles April next year. So we want all the members to come as we consecrate the apostle in that office. During the next year, during the 2022 Power Conference. Our church has been in rented headquarters office for too long. The money we are spending in Liberty Plaza, it can buy some of you cars or motorbikes or something else. And so we are going to come back to Ruma. Mungu atuhurumie, hiyo pesa tunatupa kule Liberty Plaza, Flaza inaweza kutusaidia kununua ploti mahali na kujenga headquarters mahali. Yes. It is better we operate when we are humble without struggling. Sometimes we struggle even to get money to pay. Oh, the guy is asking for money, we need to go. What should we do? We want to come back home. When we are back home here, we can operate having money. Even the big presiding bishop and the general government sometimes they struggle, no money even for their, whatever we assist them with to struggle the way they are struggling. Even sometimes we reach to a point whereby there is no allowance even because of what? That office we are paying. How much are we paying them?
4.5 million
a year. What? 8.8, whatever. What is that per year? And they went in the struggles of daily, everything, you know, whatever other struggle we go. We are spending a lot of money. We went there by mistake. Because if we repent that sin, God will open other doors for us. Because God who brought us in Yoruba, and many people have come from different countries to be Yoruba, you know, to have the mass of God here. Why can't we stay here for God to give us directions? I have talked to my son and we are working on something which is going to surprise you. Where is Johnny? Can you come here? Our church has been rented and quarters also for too long. We have tried to look for land in the city, but it seems very expensive. I feel it is the right time we have outgrown of, we have our own offices. Since we have our own land here at Yoruba, where RGC started, I direct the governing council and the Yoruba RGC leadership to agree on how this is going to be done. Not in a emergency, but slow by slow. I direct the presiding bishop, Dr. Kefa Omai, and the GS to ensure all what I have said today is implemented immediately. This whole Tonga Union is this.
Amen.
Wakapu Nambubale, our bishop. Are you serious? Wakapu Nambubale, Simameni. Even before I ordain you, from today you are bishop.
Let's do this. It will be